Hi friends, first of all myself, I'm Divya Rani from BSc BHC group from TTWRDC Women's College from Medak, and my subject is chemistry and my topic is about atomic structure and my guide name is Benazin ma'am and my house master name is Ishwatna ma'am. Today I'm going to say about atomic structure. First of all, what is mean by atomic structure? Atomic structure is nothing but atomic structure refers to the structure of an atom comprising in a nucleus in which protons and neutrons are present. Okay, next matter consists of elements are made up of atoms have subatomic particles. In subatomic particles there are three types. They are protons, neutrons and electrons. Once again, matter consists of elements are made up of atoms is nothing but atoms are tiny particles, minute particles. Okay, atoms have subatomic particles. There are three types: protons, neutrons and electrons. And the next one is atomic structure. Atoms are composed of two regions. Their first one is nucleus and second one is electron cloud. First, nucleus. What is nucleus? Nucleus is nothing but the center of the atom that contains the mass of the atom. Center, red color. In the diagram, you can see red color part that is known as center part, that is known as nucleus. Okay? And the second one is electron cloud. Electron cloud is nothing but the electron cloud region that surrounds the nucleus that contains most of the space in the atom. In the diagram, we can see clearly that around the nucleus there is an empty or hollow space. That empty or hollow space we can say that electron cloud. Okay, next one is bowling ball atomic model. What is it? Bowling ball atomic model. Bowling ball atomic model was discovered by John Dalton. Who is discovered bowling ball atomic model? John Dalton. John Dalton was born in 1766 in Cumberland in England and he was died in 1844. John Dalton proposed one theory. That theory name is bowling ball atomic model. And his theory says that the atoms are indivisible spheres that are neither created nor destroyed. The atoms are in first point. The atoms are indivisible. Indivisible means minute. We cannot see with our naked eyes. Okay? Indivisible spheres that are neither. We cannot be created or destroyed. Second point. Atoms of the same element are identical. What is it? Atoms of the same element are identical. Means atoms have the same element, have same masses and same properties. Okay? And the third point is atoms of different elements have different masses. Third point is atoms of different elements have different masses. And the fourth point is atoms can be rearranged and combined in a fixed ratios to form compound. Fourth one is atoms can be rearranged and combined in a fixed ratio to form compound. One element combines with other element to form compound. That is the fourth point. And next one, atomic structure. All the matter is made up of atoms. Atoms have two regions. We have said above. They are nucleus and the electron cloud. First, the nucleus is made up of, in nucleus, is composed of protons and neutrons. Okay, in nucleus there is protons and neutrons are present. And the second one is the electron cloud only contains electrons. In the, we can set that empty hollow space electron cloud, in that only electrons are present, not neutrons and protons. Only electrons are present in the electron cloud. Next, protons are positive. One AMU. What is mean by AMU? AMU is nothing but atomic mass unit. Second one is neutron. Neutrons are neutral. that is also one AMU. One atomic mass unit. Third one is electron. Electrons are negative, that is 0 AMU. Here the electron is denoted by negative charge, and the proton is denoted by positive charge, and the neutron is denoted by neither positive nor negative charge. In carbon atom, we can clearly see there are three spheres. They are green color, orange color and blue color. Here the green color charge is known as electrons, and the blue color sphere is known as, that is, proton, and the orange color ball sphere is known as neutrons. Neutrons nothing but they are neither positive nor negative. Okay, next one is plum pudding model. We have learned that in 9th class plum pudding model. Plum pudding model is theory was discovered by Joseph John Thomson. Who is he? Joseph John Thomson. He was born in Ohitam Hill in England. He Thomson discovered the electron in 1897. Who discovered the electron? Joseph John Thomson discovered the electron in 1897, and he, in his theory, plum pudding model theory, he used a cathode ray tube to show of any element emit particles with a negative charge. What is that? He used a cathode ray tube to show any element emits the particles with a negative charge. If any element is emits with a negative charge, he used a cathode ray tube. Okay. Next one is, he discovered that the electrons were placed randomly in a positive matrix. And the third point is, he discovered that electrons were placed in positive matrix. They are in diagram, we can see clearly they are arranged one positive, 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 negative, negative, randomly movement they are arranged. Positive one charge, one negative charge, one positive charge, one negative charge. Okay, and the third one is came up with the plum pudding model. We have said that he discovered that the model is plum pudding model. Okay, next. Rutherford's atomic model. His full name is Ernest Rutherford. He was born in 1871 and he was died in 1937. Who born in 1871? Ernest Rutherford was born in 1871 and he was died in 1937. Okay? Rutherford's atomic model. He also proposed one model that is known as Rutherford's atomic model. And that is first point. Atom has positively charged central part. In atom, positively charged central part. In central part, is nothing but nucleus. Second one, electrons are distributed around the nucleus. What is it? Electrons are distributed around the nucleus. Around the nucleus, electrons are distributed. That is the second point. And the third point is, mass of an atom is concentrated at nucleus. What is that? Mass of an atom is concentrated at nucleus. Okay? Next, fourth point. Compared with total volume of an atom, the volume of nucleus is meager. What is it? What is mean by meager? Quality or extent or large. Deficient amount or extent or large. What meaning of meager? Fourth one. Compared with total volume of an atom, the volume of nucleus is meager. Okay, that is Ernest Rutherford's atomic model. Completed. Next, Niels Bohr. Niels Bohr was born in 1885 in Copenhagen. Copenhagen, Denmark, and he was died in 1962. Niels Bohr was born in 1885 in Copenhagen, Denmark, and died in 1962. And his theory, Niels Bohr proposed one theory, okay? And his theory is nothing but in the first one, an atom is made up of protons which are concentrated in the nucleus. First point is, an atom is made up of protons. An atom is made up of protons which are concentrated in the nucleus. Okay? And the second point is, electron orbit around the nucleus along concentric orbital path. In that second point is known as, around the nucleus there is orbits. We can see in the structure diagram. There is first in the center region there is nucleus is present. Around the nucleus four orbits are present. They are nothing but K, L, M, N paths. Okay? And the third point is, electrons have quantized energy levels and they can transfer from one orbit to another. In this, from nucleus to n shell, the electrons will transfer from K shell to n shell. From one orbit to another orbit, the electrons will move, transfer. Okay? This is known as Niels Bohr's theory. Okay? Quantum numbers theory. In the next, what is quantum numbers? Next topic is quantum numbers. What is quantum number? Quantum number is nothing but the number is used for completely characterizing each electron of atom are known as quantum number. The numbers used for completely characterizing each electron, characterizing the each electron of atom are known as quantum numbers. There are four types of quantum numbers are present. Okay? First, such quantum numbers found to be necessary for describing an electron completely. For electron describing process, there are four quantum numbers are present. Okay? They are, first one is principal quantum number, second one is azimuthal quantum number, third one is magnetic quantum number, and fourth one is spin quantum number. Principal quantum number. What is mean by principal quantum number? Principal quantum number is nothing but it is denoted by n. It refers to the size and energy of an orbital and shell. Principal quantum number is denoted by L, n, and its numbers are n is equals to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like this, etc. Okay? And the third one is, greater value of n represents bigger orbit with high energies. Greater values of n represent bigger orbits with high energies. Okay? And the fourth one is, distance from the nucleus also increases. We can see in the structure, in the diagram. First, middle center path is nucleus, and the second, n is equals to orbits electron path. N is equals to 1, n is equals to 2, n is equals to 3. Like this, from nucleus to n is equals to 3, from nucleus to distance, energy will increases, not decreases. Okay? That is principal quantum number. Next, second one is azimuthal quantum number or subsidiary quantum number, and other name is angular momentum quantum number. This azimuthal quantum number is denoted by small letter L, and it defines, azimuthal quantum number defines that the shape of an orbital. Okay? Shape of an orbital like dumbbell spherical shape, dumbbell shape, double dumbbell shape, four fold shape. Okay? And its values refers, values range from 0 to n minus 1. Here, L is equal to n minus 1. Here, next one, we said they are represented by dumbbell shape, spherical shape. No, in this, if L is equals to 0, that is S orbital, spherical shape. Second one, L is equals to 1, P orbital from 1 of 3, it is known as dumbbell shape. Next, L is equals to 2, D orbital, 1 of 5, it is known as double dumbbell shape. Next, L is equals to 3, F orbital, 1 of 7, it is known as fourfold dumbbell shape. Okay, completed. Next one is magnetic quantum number. Magnetic quantum number is denoted by M, small ml. This magnetic quantum number describes the orientation of an orbital. What it describes? The orientation of an orbital. For S orbital, one L is equals to 0 and M is equals to 0. If S orbital, L is equals to 0, then M is equals to 0. And if one L is equals to 1 and M is equals to plus 1, 0, minus 1. And if L is equals to 2 and M is equals to minus 2, minus 1, 0, plus 1 and plus 2. In the diagram we can see clearly. Okay. Next, the fourth quantum number name is spin quantum number. What is that? Spin quantum number. Spin quantum number is denoted by ms, small ms. Spin quantum number is denoted by ms. In the 1920s, it was discovered that two electrons in the same orbital do not have exactly the same energy. What is that? In the 1920s, it was discovered that two electrons in the same orbital do not have exactly the same energy. Okay, next one is, the second point is, the spin of an electron describes its magnetic field, which affects its energy. What is that? The spin of an electron describes its magnetic field, which affects its energy. In this spin quantum number, it describes the direction of an electrons. Okay, what is that? If this electron moves in clockwise or anti-clockwise direction. Okay, in this, from left to right, it moves from left to right moves. It is an clockwise direction. What is that? Clockwise direction. In the diagram we can see from left to right, if it moves from left to right, it is clockwise direction. If from right to left, it anti-clockwise direction, it will move from anti-clockwise direction, it is known as minus half or anti-clockwise direction. Okay, these are the topics we can see in atomic structure. I think that you all are enjoyed with this class. Thank you so much. Bye friends.